Actually, Valley of the Gods is a real place in Utah, a very strange place, a rocky desert, with the most amazing rock formations that look like humans, torsos, busts, giant faces, horse riders. Once I was walking with a Navajo location scout through the Valley of the Gods. Suddenly he stopped and I went forward. And he grabbed my shoulder, pulled me back, and I didn't know what's going on, and I asked him what's happening, and he just put his finger on his lips. So I stood there, silent, with him for a few minutes. It was a long time, I mean, good few minutes. And then he moved without a word. And I followed him and I asked him, why did we stop? What happened? What was the reason? And he said, you most likely haven't seen it, but a herd of Mustangs, dead Mustangs, just ran across our path. They passed us by. And I just looked back and I saw a pillar of smoke, of dust. I had the sensation that I'm seeing these horses. So the Navajo people see things that we don't see. And it's amazing. It's really amazing to be with them and to be guided by them through this supposedly barren land, this deserted space, which is full of life and signs and ancestors and their souls who talk to them. My film has a very strong ecology and environmental aspect as well. I mean, the richest guy in the world tries to buy the Valley of the Gods, the holy place of Navajo people, to mine uranium ore. It's what is happening right now. There's a lot of mineral treasures at the reservations that various businesses are trying to get hold of in order to mine it, dig it, take away by ripping apart the country. It's a very actual theme. What's also interesting to me is that when I showed this film to the Navajo community, one of them said to me, "Listen, this is the first film that is told through our eyes."